So let's get started with the first section. We observed that businesses never operate in isolation. They always work together with other businesses, with governments, with banks, with all different types of organizations within markets. And effectively, wealth is generated by the flow of goods and services across these business networks. And markets could actually also be of two different types. We can actually have an open market, such as an auction, or a private market, such as things like a supply chain financing or bonds exchange. So effectively, these business networks are fundamental to the application of blockchain, as I'll come and describe as we go through the rest of the presentation. So assets are transferred across the business network, and we also observe that assets are of two different types. Fundamentally, there are tangible assets like your house or your car, and there are intangible assets like a piece of digital music or a financial instrument such as a bond or a piece of intellectual property. These would be examples of intangible assets. And we also observe on the right-hand side of the screen that cash is also an asset which has the interesting property of anonymity. Effectively, I don't know if I'm given a 5-euro note, where that 5-euro note came from, and also where it's going to go to after I've owned it. So ledgers are the key to effectively recording the flow of assets in and out of an organization. The ledger's updated every time a transaction occurs. For example, if I'm passing an asset between myself and another member of the business network, we both update our ledger when that transaction occurs. Usually the flow of the transfer of the asset is governed by a contract. And we also observe that these contracts can actually be very simple, like I give my car to another party, or they could also be governed by a slightly more complicated form of contract. But effectively, as I say, ledgers are the key to this. They record which assets flow into and out of an organization. Now, we haven't talked about blockchain very much up to now. Let's actually bring blockchain into the picture. Blockchain at the very highest level is a trusted distributed ledger which has a shared set of business processes across all the members of the business network. That's it. If someone asks you in the elevator, what is blockchain? This is what we should actually effectively be telling them.